My childhood bedroom is like something out of a movie. Except I just turned 23. I live here because I graduated college with a film degree in the middle of a global pandemic. My friends live in different places all over the country. I'm not a teenager anymore. And trying to make a life for myself as an adult from the confines of my childhood bedroom is literally making me go crazy. When I decided to move back here somewhat long term at the end of 2021, I knew my room had to change. It was essentially being used as storage for all my stuff from my dorms and apartments in college, which isn't practical now that I'm actually living here. Even more than that, I felt like my room was plagued with negative energy from all I've put it through over the years. From being a lonely, depressed, antisocial teenager, spending most of my time staring at a screen, to reverting back to being a lonely, depressed, antisocial college student when the pandemic made me have to abandon my new life in a city to shelter in place in my hometown. Like me, my room had been through a lot over the past few years. I had to restore some goodness into it. I started watching a lot of YouTube videos of girls making over their bedrooms. I wanted to get inspiration for my room, and I also wanted to avoid having to go through my emporium of sentimental objects and confront my former self. Unlike the comfort I get from my favorite movies and shows, with characters who have rooms that are bursting with coziness and personality, these influencer rooms leave me feeling kind of empty. These rooms are styled for consumption, designed to be aspirational, not necessarily indicative of teenage items accumulating on top of a girlhood that's passing by. Besides that, it seems like every girl now has an area in her room designated for work. They all have a pristinely organized desk, decorated with plastic objects designed to give productivity the illusion of fun. I mean, it makes sense. Teenagers now are expected to function like mini adults, available to email their teachers after school hours, expected to do hours of homework each day, and fill up their free time with extracurriculars. And young adults like myself are working from home, or like me, are unemployed and trying to figure it out with their childhood bedroom as their headquarters. A 23-year-old who has to find the internal drive every day to sit at her desk and work on the computer, writing networking emails, editing videos, building my personal brand, or any other attempt to turn my creativity into a career, can't possibly do that in a pink room full of reminders of what my life was like in high school. I thought about taking down all the art, getting rid of all the books and stuffed animals, painting the walls, and getting a white bedspread. But who would I be if I turned my teenage palace into an office?
Literally move this.
Yeah.
Like there.
Yeah.
So I just need these ones.
Okay.
I'm gonna take this Wendy down.
Wendy?
Do you remember I like ripped this all to hell?
Yeah. No. Why?
I was trying to hang it up in my nook. I really should have done this the other way.
To take it down?
Yeah.
You live and you learn.
Oh, Christ.
That doesn't sound good.
That looks good.
All right.
Is yours touching?
Uh-huh.
Okay. My childhood home was built in 1945. When we first moved here in 2005, it hadn't been updated since 1986. My room had blue carpet and round windows. We replaced the carpet and I requested it be painted Tinkerbell green. When I was 10, my dad turned the eave of the house into what we call my nook, a once magical place for reading and napping that is now basically storage for the contents of my former dorm room. As I entered my adolescence, I had outgrown the green room and wanted to change. I chose this odd combination of purplish brown and orangey red, which I actually think is still really cool.
After that paint job, I never thought my room would change drastically, until a harsh New York winter caused a leaky roof and a substantial ice dam that destroyed the exterior wall. The room had to be renovated and the entire roof taken off and replaced. And in my dad's effort to stretch the insurance money and advocate for an even cooler palace for his only daughter, he said, "Why not raise the ceiling?" My sophomore year of high school, I lived in the guest room and came back to 15-foot-high cathedral ceilings, a walk-in closet converted from the other eaves of the house, beautiful cherry beams, tons of natural light, and a perfect feminine yet sophisticated paint color called cashmere wrap. It was magic. Even though I was profoundly lonely in high school, and it weighed heavily on my spirit, it wasn't all bad. I am so lucky to have had a beautiful, spacious, quiet place to come home to where my parents always respected my privacy and invested their time and money into making this room perfect. I started watching movies to fill my time, and I started feeling like I wanted to make them too. I collected books about acting and filmmaking from used bookstores and read them methodically, even taking notes in an effort to build a personal database of information on my new obsession. This was the place where I laid the groundwork for what I wanted to do with the rest of my life. Then I went away to college and I felt like my life was finally changing for the better. And then the pandemic happened, and I moved back to this room, and for 2 years, that relentless desire I had to be a filmmaker seemed to vanish overnight.
My Girl Scout Gold Award, I'm actually like really proud of this, because I worked really hard for it and like did it on my own. This is like all my old saxophone music. This is crazy. I don't even remember playing most of these songs, which is crazy because I spent so much time playing this stuff. Like, these are my IB art journals. When I took IB art, you have to like document all the projects you make with these journals, and I worked so hard on mine, and I actually love doing this. To me, like, these are sort of more personal than my written journals in a way, because it's like my actual creativity is in these and not just like my thinking about my creativity. I made this binder, I want to say when I was like 16 or 17, to like keep track of my like career in film that I wanted to have, and I worked so hard on this. Felt like such a waste of time to like care about this shit when I was feeling like so uninspired to make films or act or like do any of the things that I set out to do when I was a teenager. And I haven't looked in here since 2019 probably. It felt like the only thing I could do, like read about things that I hope to do, that I hoped I would have the opportunity to do, and just like plan for that because I couldn't actually do it even though I wanted to do it so bad. Like, it just reminds me of like feeling trapped like that, and it just like makes me sad to look at how much hope I had for the future and how much energy I had to try to do something that I had literally never done before and never known anyone who had done anything like it.
Thank you.
push down. Okay, I guess no, that's fine.
Do you think it's crooked?
No, it doesn't look crooked.
I know, and I drilled it until it clicked.
Oh, that's way off.
Or something.
It's so freaking weird.
It's effing IKEA.
Well, normally this doesn't happen.
Mm-hmm.
Well, buddy, don't push down on it at the beginning. Just
oh,
get
really?
It started, and then when you need to finish it, then you push down on it. Yeah, now push down on it. Here, can I give you one more tip? Bend at the here instead of here.
Protects your wrist.
Yeah, you get more leverage. Yeah. No, that's not gonna do it. Look, one of these.
Don't break the fucking thing.
See?
Can you go in our room and put on your glasses?
Why? I can see. No. Is this the right screwdriver? I can't see anything.
A social media influencer.
Yeah. Now you screw them. Do you have to make them?
It's a lineup. 20 different things.
And it was hard when I like was by myself.
So how'd you do it?
You just like do it, kind of.
No, I think it's actually a problem with the design.
Yeah, everyone's a hater.
I didn't say anything.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, it's the same story as before. Everyone's a hater.
It's literally the same hole.
I'm just gonna force it this time.
Why?
Why not?
Because it will break.
So what? I'm not gonna use it anyway.
Yes, you are. Don't break it.
What do you mean, yes, you are? We left it out last time.
But I mean, because I don't want this to like split. Mm-mm. And then it will be putting pressure on this, and over time it will break.
Yeah, probably.
So like do the math and use your brain.
You know what? I do think the whole thing is machined wrong, because this should go all the way in.
Yeah, it's shittily built.
See, it should go, you know, it should be flush, not sticking out like that.
Yeah. That's why you need to run me my check.
Look at how complicated that is.
How come there's all that detritus on the bed while you're filming?
Because that's the way it is. Oh, look. we need to touch up the paint there.
Yeah, you didn't think about that?
Well, what do you mean? What am I supposed to do about it?
You're the one who has that.
I think
paint.
That we used the last ounce of this paint when we
You
were
didn't
painting.
Think about that?
George, do you remember when we were...
Oh shit.
Whoa.
Pretty nice.
It's got a little dent. And plug right there.
Yep.
How much more perfect can it get?
Literally couldn't get more perfect.
Doop-dee-doop-dee-doo.
That'll hide the plug.
It's adorable.
Plug-a-rug. That is adorable.
It's pretty cute.
It says Frigidaire on it.
I just need some beer. So my idea for my crochet film is to have... I'm like sitting here crocheting and there's like a voiceover.
Uh-huh.
And I like... wrote a narration of like what I'm thinking as I'm crocheting, and then there's like images playing on the projector of like what I'm thinking as I'm crocheting.
Yeah.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah, that's very cool. What is this? Wizard of Oz?
No, meet me in St. Louis. St. Louis? I don't know.
So what else do we have to ask? It's getting so old.
Help me hold on. You know, there's this thing people say about celebrities that they're frozen at the age they got famous. And that's kind of what happened to me. I had a lot of growing up to do.
When this movie came out in 2019, I couldn't relate to this at all. I thought this was indicative of how fame caused her to become removed from real life, to miss out on normal experiences of young adulthood that help someone grow up. When I watch it now, I empathize with her completely. I feel frozen at age 20, the age I was when the pandemic happened. On March 14th, 2020, I moved back to my parents' house, back to the room I was trapped in for all of my adolescence, and now almost 3 years later, I still haven't found a place in this world outside of this room. I finished college remotely. I never went to another football game or party. Much of my first relationship developed long distance from the confines of this bedroom because of the pandemic. I've never experienced love outside of these circumstances. My time spent here in 2020 resulted in the worst depression I've ever experienced. I had no creative ideas. I didn't make a film for 2 years. I wasn't curious about anything. I barely had energy to even do my schoolwork. For a long time, I was really scared I would never feel like myself again. And as time goes on and life doesn't return to normal, not really, not like how I thought it would, how am I supposed to grow up?
Clothes in here. This room is really cool.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Bro.
Boom.
See, it fits perfect.
Which side? Left.
Where did you get this mattress? Do you remember?
On the side of the road?
No. My landlord gave it to me in Switzerland.
So who knows?
It's got a long history.
Who knows what's been done
or said on that mattress?
I know what's been done and said on that mattress.
We don't want to know.
We don't want to know.
Whoa.
Sorry. Okay, where?
Actually, it'll go this way, maybe.
Oh yeah.
That's like a headboard right there.
Yeah, wait, perfect actually. I'm having fun.
Your house is going to be perfect, and then this, the moment you open and close the front door, the whole thing is going to go...
First step is leveling a picture.
Just like in Deadpool, when the grandma assembled the IKEA.
Oh, yeah.
I love that.
Queen, I just leveled it.
It wasn't level.
Oh, it's really bad now. Look at that. Now step back, Annie. Leveling doesn't help, you gotta slide it.
Fuck it, you do it. You do it. It's hard.
I can't. I'm gonna move all this so my closet door will actually close.
Yeah.
Maybe we could go right here.
The runaway? Yeah. This room is a maximalist room, right?
Yeah.
What the hell is a maximalist?
It's where you put shit
so you
everywhere.
Have a lot of stuff.
That's called hoarding.
We get called hoarders.
It's a design style.
We get called hoarders, she gets called maximalist.
This is presented beautifully.
To the left a little bit, do you think, Josh?
Yeah,
like
right there.
That's good.
And then we'll center this one later.
A little more to the right.
To the right. The left picture, go to the right.
There. Not too much. Yeah, right there.
That's good.
Okay. Like centered?
Yeah, definitely. Let me level this bitch.
This design is rarer because this was the original plate, and the current Alaska plate is this remade because they're into like the vintage theme with the bear. But this one is also cool because
it says protection.
It says protection, which means it belonged to the Fish and Wildlife Service.
Hmm.
So don't you want my Northwest Territories in the shape of a polar bear right beneath it?
I'm gonna get rid of these little planets. I'm tired of them.
Put one inside the crystal box.
Are they all the planets?
I'm missing... Or are they? How many planets are there?
Well, there were 9, now there's 8.
Yeah, I have 8. Slay.
Yeah, why? Because somebody stopped eating the planet?
Yeah, Pluto.
Pluto stopped.
Pluto got canceled. Demoted.
I really stuck.
Really don't like this?
Well, it's weird to have Eleanor and then have Eleanor diploma right above
it.
Yeah,
it's a little bit like high school. All
right. You know, I admire these Eleanor letters every time I go in here. But no more. I'm going to hang them up in the shop.
Oh, Lord. When you throw something out, it's in practice.
Nope. Look at
it. You're a hoarder.
That's cool. Oh, I see.
Wow. I wonder if having them in the Hexy is going to give them extra power.
I fear it will.
Ironically enough, in order to figure out how to be 22 in this room, I started thinking about what it was like to be 12. I remember feeling understimulated, desperate for new experiences that I was deprived of as a preteen with working parents and few friends in a small town. I remember my voracity for knowledge that vanished when I became depressed during the pandemic. When I was interested in something back then, it's all I could think about, and I devoted most of my waking hours to learning about it. And the internet was my substitute for the experiences I couldn't find in real life. It started with makeup. I was desperate to grow up, to be a teenager, to express my femininity, and makeup was the way I wanted to do it. In my nook, I started watching YouTube videos of girls a few years older than me, and learned literally everything I could from the internet about makeup. Looking back on this time in my life now, and on the time spent in this bedroom, I feel more connected to my 12-year-old self than I ever have. Watching makeup videos on YouTube in my girlhood was the first time I ever taught myself a new skill. It was taking control of my life, finding an avenue outside my limited circumstances, to be empowered to learn something new. These are the first girls I saw telling stories with a camera, arguably the first example of female filmmaking I ever saw. When I look back on my isolation in my room 10 years ago, watching YouTube videos, reading books, practicing the skills I learned, having the space to be myself in private, is exactly what I want to feel now in this room at 22. Thinking about my journey now as a filmmaker, teaching myself how to do professional audio and camera work, thinking about story in a deep way, committing to practicing what I learn and showing it to people, I can trace it back to being in this room, watching YouTube videos. I wasn't merely copying what I saw in those girls who I so deeply identified with, but I was absorbing their wisdom of adolescence and synthesizing it into my version of the person I knew I was supposed to be. Why would I want to run from my girlhood when it's the reason I'm here, making films right now? So I didn't paint the walls white, I kept them cashmere wrap. the cutest, coziest color that I still love so much. I didn't take down my One Direction posters, I just moved them to a better place. I didn't get rid of my stuffed animals, I added more of them. I made these quilts with my mom to add even more color and texture to my walls. I painted these wooden hexagons to have somewhere to put my crystals to restore some positive energy in here. The stuff in my room is a badge of honor. It reminds me of my travels, my struggles, my girlhood that I fought so hard to survive and now I'm fighting so hard to honor. And over the course of the past year of making these changes, I'm actually more creatively productive than ever. Now at almost 23, I have the courage to do what I wanted to do when I was 13, right here in the room I grew up in.